my channel Avanti Morocha. This video is in collaboration with Cricut and I'm going to show you 10 things about Cricut Design Space. Now, let's begin! Design Space is a web-based program. To use it on your computer, you need to be connected to the internet. The program is linked to your Cricut account, which you get when you buy a Cricut machine. With Design Space, you can create projects from scratch or you can use ready-to-make projects. If you are subscribed to Cricut Access, you can use any of the images that have a green A in front of them. I'm going to insert this image. Also, with Cricut Access, you can use any of Cricut fonts that have a green A in front of them. You can also upload your own images and designs in the following file formats: JPEG, GIF, PNG, BMP, SVG, and DXF. You can also use system fonts, which are the ones that came with your computer or you have purchased or downloaded. Cricut Design Space can be installed on Windows or Mac computers. It can be a desktop or a laptop. You can also download the app in iOS or Android devices. The following image shows a comparison of Cricut Design Space featureability across Design Space platforms. The core features are available in all platforms. At the moment, the print and cut feature is not available on Android devices. The features of pattern fill, templates, lean physical cartridge, curved text, and knife blade cutting are only available when using Design Space on a desktop or laptop computer. The smart guides feature is only available on the mobile app. Finally, the offline photo canvas, 3D layer visualization, and snap mat are only available in iOS devices. I have been using a Cricut machine for more than 4 years and I haven't yet used any of these tools. None of them are indispensable tools, they are just extras. Nice to have when working on a mobile device. I'm in Design Space. Click on the top left corner, over the three lines, and open the menu. Click on Calibration. If this is your first time using any of these tools, rotary blade, knife blade, or the function of print and cut, it is best to calibrate the machine before using it. Now, click on Update Firmware. Cricut is updating its software continuously. Check here to see if you are up to date with the firmware. Design Space by default is in inches, but if you prefer, you can change the units to centimeters. Click on the three lines, open the menu, click on Settings, and now select centimeters instead of inches. Now, as you can see, the canvas is in centimeters. The template tool helps you to visualize your final project. With it, you can adjust the size until you are happy with the results. As you can see, there is a large variety to choose from. I'm going to select one based on the categories. Go to Fashion. The template I use the most is the classic t-shirts. When you add a template to the canvas, you get a message that says, "Templates are for reference only and will be not saved with your project." Now I'm going to select the template layer. This allows me to see its options. If you want, you can change the fill color of the t-shirt. Select the type of t-shirt you want. I want a woman's t-shirt, short sleeve, and size small. Insert the image of your preference. I'm going to modify the dimensions until I'm happy with how it looks on the t-shirt. Now, click on Make It. Remember, the template is not going to show in the final product. Now, I want to talk a little more about Print Then Cut when you have a subscription for Cricut Access. Click on Images. Go to Filter and check the box for Printables. These are Cricut images designed for Print Then Cut. You can use any of the images with the green A in front. I'm going to select this flower and click on Insert. As you can see in the layer panel, the actions are Cut and Print. Now I'm going to insert another kind of image and check printables and check the box for single layer. These are images that only have one layer. Insert this image. As you can see in the layer panel, the only action here is cut. To be able to use this image for print and cut, follow the next steps. Add a shape. Change the fill color so that you can see it. Arrange it to the back. Place it underneath the design. Select both elements and click on Flatten. Now, if you check the layer panel, the actions are Cut and Print. Now I'm going to select a multi-layer image. Voy a insertarla. As you can see in the layer panel, this image has 4 layers and the action is cut. However, I want to use this image to make stickers. Select all the layers of the image and click on Flatten. Now the actions are cut and print. You can also buy licensed images, Disney, Star Wars, Sesame Street and more. These images can only be used for personal projects. I'm going to insert this image. This image has 3 layers and the action is cut. I'm going to reduce the size. Now insert a circle. Change the fill color. Arrange it to the back. Select both images and click on Align Center. Select both elements and click on Flatten. Now the actions are Cut and Print. If you want to learn more about Print Then Cut, check my video about this topic. Now I'm going to show you how to edit a single layer image. I want to remove the word Market from the sign. Insert a square. Change the dimensions and cover the word Market with it. Now select both elements and click on Slice. I'm going to remove all the pieces that I don't need. Now I have designed like I wanted. Now I'm going to show you how to share your Cricut projects with the community. You can only share projects that use Cricut images. Save the project and don't forget to check the box in public. I have already done it. Now go to Projects. Go to Categories, click on My Projects. I'm going to share this project. To share the project, add a photo, make the project visible to others, name the project and add a description. Click on Save. Now you can share your project on Facebook or Pinterest. To use this project, you need to have Cricut Access, or if you prefer, you could buy the images individually from Cricut. I hope you like this video and you find it informative. If you have any questions, leave them in the comment section. If you are interested in getting a Cricut, I'm going to leave you the link where you can buy it in the info box below the video.
If you are new to my channel and you like what you see, hit the subscription button, tap the notification bell so you get informed every time I release a new video. Don't forget to visit my blog, follow me on my social media, like this video, and share it with your loved ones. See you soon. Ciao, ciao.